Hey guys, Allison here. Well, I want to talk to my single friends today because I know a lot of single people, especially good Catholic women and Catholic men, really would like to be married and really would like to be happy and raise a family. And yet, it may not be happening for you right away, or maybe it's been a real big struggle. Here's my advice. If you want to be happily married, don't get married until you're happy. And what do I mean by that? You know, too often we don't work on ourselves, or there are wounds from the past that we hope that a marriage is going to heal. Or we're kind of like chameleons. We'll kind of, be like the guy that we meet or the girl that we meet. And, we really need to know who we are and learn to be happy with who we are. Now, how do we do that? Now, first off, if we have wounds from the past, and most people do, we all have something that we had to deal with growing up, right? But if you have some significant wounds, if you came from a dysfunctional family, maybe you've had dysfunctional relationships or abusive relationships in the past, maybe you were bullied as a kid, whatever it is, you want to really work on healing those wounds, and talking to a Catholic therapist would be really helpful, which is why I set up CatholicTherapist.com. All right, talk to somebody and look at those wounds and bring them to the light, bring them to God for healing. Because once you're healed, then you're going to be free to be the person that God created you to be, and you're going to be a lot happier. If you're always struggling with depression or anxiety or whatever it is, a marriage doesn't help that. Sometimes it can make it even worse, right, if we don't marry the right person. The other thing that I think we need to do is really learn who we are. Now, that's where Catholic coaching can come in really, really handy, to kind of really explore, what are my talents and strengths? Who do I want to be? Maybe you have goals. Maybe there are things you would like to do and accomplish in life, but you're not getting there. And, all the great athletes, all the great singers, all the great actors, they all have coaches. So, often we're kind of doing this alone as Catholics, like living this Catholic life. But I think it could be really helpful. I set up Catholic life coaches for that reason, because I think when we are living and being the person that God created us to be, and we have that strength, you are going to attract the right person to yourself. And you're going to know what's right for you and what's not right for you. So I think that's the best advice I can give to somebody. When you get to the point where, hey, I like myself, I have a good life, there are things that, maybe there's something missing. Sure, of course, when you're not, when you long to be married, there's going to be something missing. But work on yourself, work on being the best version of who God created you to be, and pray. Pray. God has a plan. Sometimes it doesn't happen in our time, but He has the perfect plan and the perfect person for you if you're willing to wait. Too often we settle. One of the things that I've noticed is a lot of people marry whoever they happen to be dating at the time that they decide is right to get married. Men do that a lot, I think. So I think to be more discerning, to kind of say, well, what kind of person, what kind of lifestyle do I want to live? Is this person compatible with me? Because, really we have to know who we are to know if the other person is compatible, right? So that's my advice. If you want to be happily married, don't get married till you're happy, till you're happy with you. So I hope you find that helpful. Please share this video, particularly with any single friends or kids that you might have, because I think that, I know a lot of people are hurting and struggling and waiting. And I know I waited a very long time before I met my husband. When I got to that point where I was really happy with myself, I was really happy with my life and the many blessings that God had given me, I never stopped praying. I always prayed and I always trusted. Not always, I shouldn't say that. I didn't always trust. I got very frustrated many times. But by just working on myself, just being grateful for the many blessings, the many friends, and the great work I had to do, that really made a big difference. And that's when things really turned around, when I just made that decision. And happiness is a decision. So make that decision to be happy with who you are, with all the blessings in your life. Keep improving, keep working on it, and trust, because God has the perfect plan. God bless you.